Hello everybody, welcome back. This is Nick with Tom Schaefer's RV. Today we're going over the all-new 2023 Imagine XLS 21BH. This is a non-slide unit. As you can tell from this side, there's no slide outs that come out this side. There's no slide outs that come out the campsite. So this is a non-slide unit. This is also going to be about 25 foot long, tip to toe. The 21BH stands for 21 is about 21 foot of the box of the unit. And then you give or take 4 feet for the hitch. Every single hitch on the travel trailer, you're taking about 4 feet for the hitch. So take that about 25 foot tip to toe. We're gonna check the inside of this unit, the outside, show you the storage and all around of what you guys wanna see. If you guys are looking for a unit that's gonna have a bunkhouse and you're gonna want some space, but you don't have the biggest unit to tow with, you can still get something like this and you're gonna have enough room inside for the kids to relax and enjoy the night. And also the Murphy bed makes it where you have an extra seating space inside as well. So let's go take a look at this unit. All right, let's dig into the outside of this 21BHE. As you see up front, you're gonna start with two 20 pound propane tanks. You get your electric tongue jack there too. We're gonna start on the non-camp side, which is gonna be the off-door side of this unit. For the weights, so we're gonna look at the weights here first. So the weights on this unit, if you go over to this sticker, so your unloaded is gonna be 4892, and that's how the unit sits right now on my lot. If you look at the gross, you're gonna be about 6395. That gross is what the two axle of this unit can handle. So it can handle up to 6,395 pounds. And then as you go and look into the storage over here, you are going to have your 110 outlets there, your cable hookup. You are gonna have your battery disconnect. You got your solar charger, so it tells you how much you're charging. You can do your city and your fresh tank fill here. And this is your city fill here. And then you get an outside shower there. And then everything with Grand Design's wet bay is you're gonna have this, which opens up. So if you come fully underneath the unit, if you can see, you're gonna be able to hook everything up and through, which is really nice. So then you can essentially take this and close it. So this doesn't always need to be open, which is really nice. And then as you see the whole pass-through storage there, that is your pass-through from side to side. It is gonna be prepped with TP-Link. That is the tire link. So if you're looking to look at the pressure of your tires while traveling, you can hook it up with that tire link, and that's already set up for you. You just have to buy the additional tire pressure monitor gauges and the actual mini unit that slides into that slot. And then you are getting a 25 amp solar charger as well, because you do have a 12 volt refrigerator on the inside as well. And then moving on to the back of this, so you do have your vent fan cover over there. You have your fresh tank fill over here, and like I said, this is still a double axle. Even though it's a 25 foot unit, you get Goodyear tires and you get the double axle, which is always really nice when you talk to other people over a single axle unit, double axle unit. There's many reasons why double axle is always better to go with. And you do have your Suburban heater over here too, and then your black tank flushes back here, and then you have one spot for your black and gray tank. And then you are going to have manual stabilizers on this. It kind of keeps the weight down as well. The electric leveling really takes up the weight a little bit, but this, all you have to use is either arm muscle, or you can also use a drill as well. Going on to the back, so you're still going to have a walkable roof that you're going to be able to climb. So that walkable roof's capacity is about 300 pounds. I am still not that light, so I cannot use it. You still have a backup camera prepped up there. You do have your full shore power to plug in, so that is your 30 amp unit there for you. And then of course the backup taillights and everything are all LEDs now. They've all really updated to that LED lights, which is really nice. You do have a back bumper with a spare tire, and then you do have your hot water heater right here. And then your license plate holder is right down there, so it's still in plain sight, so it's not like it's hidden. Moving on to the campsite, you do get your full, I don't have the awning out right now. It is quite windy here, but you see the LED lights all underneath. And then looking at the outside kitchen, so they are coming with these new Capital griddles, which are really nice. They're pretty big, spacious, and a griddle, you can do a lot more than just a two burner stove. So really nice that they have that. And they are using the Moride, I want to say chassis or glider, honestly, it's a glider, to pull out the griddle, which makes it really nice and easy for storage and really nice and easy to take this in. And then this just slides right in with it. And then you have two locks. So you have a lock here and you have a lock on the other side. So both of that's gonna lock in place, so it's not gonna move while you're traveling. And then here you still get like a college size refrigerator, which is nice if you're on the go and you wanna keep drinks out here so you don't have to step inside the coach. But with an on-slide unit, you can get to the coach at any time. That's a big positive. And then you do have 110 outlets over here, and you do have a cable hookup, so if you're looking to put an outside TV, you can. And the other nice thing about this, you still have outdoor speakers as well. So when you're chilling outside, you still have outdoor speakers. You get the fold-up steps from underneath. You can upgrade them if you want to. A lot of them can pull out the side and go up and in. And then you can change this whole system out if you want to. But you can still do that if you want to. But with the light and this being the XLS, those are the stairs that they give you on this model. And then wrapping up the outside, this is going to be the other side of the storage for you. Alrighty, that is going to wrap up the outside of this 21 BHE. Now we're going to go take a look on the inside. What's going on, guys? Welcome to the inside of the 21 BHE. I'm going to show you guys how to take down this Murphy bed in this unit, and then we'll show you the rest of the unit after I am done with this. So to take this down, so this is going to be a little sitting area for you. So you can actually sit here during the day. You have a lot of leg room here and a lot of space. And then at night, all this is going to do, this is going to fold down for you. And then you're actually going to unpin this one side. So that's going to come on down. And then your bed just folds right out. And then you do have, I'll show you the one side, you do have a blue light. And you do have just a regular white light on each side. So if you're reading at night or need an extra light, you do have it. Each side does have a cubbyhole. So you can use a CPAP if you want to. There's 110 outlets over there, or there is USB outlets as well. So if you need to plug your phone in, you can definitely do so. You do have a curtain too. That curtain's gonna come over and create some privacy for you between you and whoever you're with. Either you have kids or you got by this and friends come with you too. You at least have private area as well. And then another big thing is, what kind of space do you have when the Murphy bed is down? So, well, if you look down here, this is going to be the start of the back of the booth dinette that's in here. And this is with the bed down. And I still have a bunch of width space here that I can walk straight through too. So you do have enough room where you're not going to bother anybody if you're going to enter and exit the unit. So that's always a nice plus too when this Murphy bed is down, that this Murphy bed's not intruding on your space to walk inside of the unit. So it's really nice. The Murphy bed is a good size. You're still a full queen size bed, which is really nice. And you're not losing any walking space coming in and out of this unit. So I'm going to show a little quick video on how to wrap this all up, and then we'll get on with the rest of this unit. All right, now we got the Murphy bed put back up. And then for the storage or your closets, you have both of these on either side. So this is the same as the other side, and you have two drawers that are gonna pop out for you. And then you still get additional little storage below hand as well. So a little door just where they see fit, especially because you're only a 25-foot unit. They try to utilize the storage as much as they can. And then you do have your TV right there that will pull out if you need to use it. That'll pull out, so if you're sitting in a dining room or kids wanna watch TV, they can. And then you still have your sink over here, your kitchen space. So you do have your storage up here. There you go. You got your cabinet up there for you. And then you do have a nice one-piece sink as well. And then this is adjustable nozzle. So if you're doing your dishes, you can wash your dishes. And then you still get storage below. So a little spice rack. And you get a little storage in there, which is nice. And then you do have drawers that are going to pop out. So you have one, two, three, and then you kind of get a pots and pans cabinet for you. And then you just still get a three burner stove, and you still get an oven, easy big oven. They're not really the biggest thing yet, but you still get a little bit of an oven. What's nice about this unit, if you guys ever seen Compass Connect, so Compass Connect is what Grand Design uses. So you can work the interior and exterior lighting, the slide outs. If this had one, you could work it on your phone. You can work the awning, and if you have tire link or anything, you can actually link your tire link all to that app. So that app has been really nice and convenient. and help people in a situation. If they have a slide out and close to a tree, they're able to see that slide out outside while pressing it on their phone, which is actually pretty cool. And then you still have your fan here above the way, as you can hear. You still have your microwave above. And when you take a turn to your left here, this is going to be your 12-volt refrigerator. And as I'm plugged in just to the 7-way plug right now, this refrigerator is running. So this is already cold. This is already freezing. It's already up and running. And what's really nice about 12-volt refrigerators, if you guys don't know, they are using them more. The propane is going away, and they are moving these 12 volts, which means there's 160-watt solar up top of here with that 25 amp, which it can trickle charge your battery, or it can keep the refrigerator running for a little bit if you do lose power somewhere. But what's nice is, so when it cools, it's pulling from inside air instead of like propane, it's pulling from the outside. So the inside there is pulling from 70 degrees in here instead of 90 on a hot day. So that's why these can use a lot less electric. So that is why they're turning to 12-volt refrigerators right now. And then to the left of that, you still have drawers here, so you can still have some storage. And then those are going to be your bunks. So you have two double-wide bunks, you have a light at each spot, and you have a USC and a USB type charger on either side with each one. And then you do have a curtain. This curtain's gonna pull around the whole way for you. It's actually tucked underneath. There we go. So that's actually gonna wrap all the way up and around for you. So they get privacy as well in the bunks. And then moving up top there is gonna be storage. And this is gonna be storage. And then you still have your booth dinette here, which if you want this table to go down, the table does go down, and then this can turn into a bed as well if you want it to. And then you do get an AC. So your AC is above here, and then you do have a fan area there. So you do have a little bit of a fan that's gonna turn on here. And if you're in the kitchen cooking, it's able to take all that air out if you want it to, or just provide a little bit more air and movement in here. They do give you a space. And then moving on to the bathroom, I really don't need to cut the video because it is such a smaller trailer. I can kind of do it all in one for you guys. So you open the door. That is where the door is going to open to. So you are open right into the bunks. You're opening right into the booth dinette. But with a non-slide, that is the room you're willing to accept. And then you still get your Grand Design unique towel holder. Sorry. So they do like a towel rack, towel holder, whatever you want to call it. They have that almost in every single unit. You have towel racks there if you want to hang anything. Your toilet is right there in the corner, but you still have space around it, which is nice. And then your sink. And then you still have a nice medicine, a nice area of storage underneath if you want to the left. And then you still have counter space here. You get a window. And then you do get a medicine cabinet on here cornered. Then yes, it comes with a toilet paper holder and everything too. And then what everybody talks about in these Grand Design units is the shower. So this is supposed to hook there. And what this does is when it's done, it's gonna squeegee the water back in. A lot of people like it. A lot of people really don't know how to take it, but they've been using it for so long that you can do that. Or you can use a rod and go from here to here and hang a curtain if you really want to. If this doesn't work out in your favor, that's one way to overcome the bathroom size. But even anything in this, I can't switch around the other way. But yes, I do have room when I walk into the back of this unit. I do have room here. My shoulders are gonna touch a little bit more, but I still have room in there. I wouldn't say it's too much big man approved, but if I'm looking for a quick shower, I can get one because I do have headspace because of that skylight there. But I am going to be able to take a quick shower. So that's always a positive in that. And then if I squeeze my way out of this bathroom, we'll take another little overlook of the whole unit. So that is your bunks. And then that is going to be your booth dinette. And then everything here too. So this is really what you're hooking up to when you use the the phone app. So if you press the connect up here, this is going to connect to your phone app. It's going to beep and beep blue. Make sure your Bluetooth is on. And then everything you can do from here, you're going to be able to do from your phone. So you're going to be able to check your tanks. You're going to be able to turn your lighting inside, outside, your water pump on. Your water heater, you might be able to turn on off. I forget if they do it. If not, you just do it from here. But you can do your awning as well. So that's really nice. And then all their one control passwords are right here in a barcode or a scan code. And then 12-volt refrigerator, there's your kitchen area, your TV, and then you look it back here, that is your Murphy bed. Alrighty guys, thank you for watching this walk around of the Grand Design Imagine 21BHE, and this is their XLS series. So this is a little bit lighter of a trailer. This is a 25 footer. Once again, this is a no slide. So you're taking the little room that you get here and off-centering that with a slide out, since those kind of take, you know, anywhere from 6 to 1,000 pounds, depending on the slide bigness of it. You're looking at that weight that you add on. So if you're not looking to pull with a big truck, this is definitely going to be the unit for you, and you are a double axle, so it's going to be easier to tow too, which is nice. And you still have room if you're going to hang out, like camping is supposed to be done. Then if you don't like glamping as much, then you're out in the fire. This is all you need to come in, have a space to keep your food, to sleep, to get a quick shower and go to the bathroom. This is definitely the unit you guys are looking for to start camping. You guys have any questions or anything, phone number is going to be below to give us a call. If you want to check out our inventory, our website is going to be posted in the description. We are on our way to 1,000 subscribers, hopefully soon. Just make sure you're giving us a like and subbing. We'll greatly appreciate that. And of course, in the feedback, let us know what units you want us to review. If we have them on our lot, I will be happy to do a walk around for you guys. If I don't, then I won't be able to. Maybe if we go to some shows and I see a unit, I'd be able to do a walkthrough for you guys, which we do have a show coming up next week, which is the Allentown show. So if you guys are going there, we hope to see you guys at the Allentown RV show. For now, that is the Imagine 21BHE. We will see you guys later. Have a good one.